Hello, all once again. So today I'm just not feeling too well, so I'm gonna just do some chill and farm, start a new game. Yeah, I decided to stream. My headspace was weird this morning. I lost a potential job. I beat the crap out of my left knee, and just one of those days where you just feel lonely. Oh, anyways, thanks, unicorns. Anyway, so today, oops, today, doing some chill streams. Oops, I forgot to actually set the window. Hopefully this works. There we go. Stardew Valley. And I f completely forgot to turn on the sound. Turn on my chat on my phone so I can actually see what you guys are saying. Yeah, I saw some drawings you did there. They were pretty good. How long have you been drawing for? There's actually different farms now. Actually doing some big drawings yesterday, but for like that bendy drawing I did like half a year. What do you mean? Took time to make art where I looked at Google reference and all that until Bendy Drawing I made half a year ago. Oh, I see, okay. How long have you been like, actually, what the fuck? Stupid cat. How long have you been actually drawing? Sculpting's always fun. Nice. But to be honest, I've never actually taken a art class. Cutscene. Yep. That's creepy. Nice. Oh, I got it in a second. Boy, this game is emotional. Nice. Looks good. Just as a quick note, and I only say this as a fellow artist, one thing I'd recommend is trying out different poses for things. Like, I noticed a lot of your guys kind of have like the arms to the side. Try just like practicing one day, even if it's just like a nondescript character. Oh, hey, my cousin hasn't got back to me on this, but I did think of something for the SCP game board game that I want to verify will work. Like, me verify? Also, I'm not going to put Shy Guy in a seductive pose. I'm not saying that. I'm saying, like, bending over or reaching a cabinet or, like, in the middle of a twirl. Even dabbing. Try doing a character that dabs. Not even, don't look for a reference on that kind of thing. You'd have to, like, try it yourself. Yay. But I feel like the board game could be in pieces, and you could assemble your own map, and you could put D-class cells in a spot connected hallways and move stuff around. Yeah, that's actually something. What's that game called? Give me a second now, it's gonna bother me if I don't look this up. No. Let me ask my friend. My friend has all these games, so it's like, because randomized maps are like really good. What's that game about? I have a D&D setup that would help me learn how things work. Yeah. Idiot cat was freaking in a bag. So I could put up the idea setup sheet so that people are better at creating stuff and stuff, but yeah. Well, if... Once I show you the game that I'm talking about, you'll... Because a lot of games do the similar idea of, like, pulling random cards for oops. That's a... Idiots. Stay out of there. So are my cats being a nuisance? Forbidden Sky. Okay, so I just realized my thing was on. So look for. Let's see if I can find. Here, I dropped a link for you that'll help you out. That's the game I'm talking about. I not have enough for a chest. What's the 50 wood? That is still not enough. Yeah, no worries. But I'm gonna scrap the role of playing as D class in the game, which would be new to SCP game. I would replace it with SCPs. Yeah, I can see it working. I can build a chest. Okay. how you said to have three drop piles for the three main SCP classifications. I wouldn't say even like three, just one with mixed. Or maybe two piles, one with safe and one with mixed Euclid Keter. Something like that. I don't like this guy. Better. Well, look on YouTube for something like that if I can make a recommendation, because a lot of the times you can find like people playing the game. This is nice. Halfway done. Oh, the other thing you can look at for is it's like Haunted House on the Hill or something like that. I like George. Thank you. Demetrius. That's an awesome name. Well, I mean, everything takes time. You just got to be patient. Yeah, I think next stream I'm gonna have like a chat overlay so people on YouTube aren't thinking I'm freaking crazy talking. Thanks, Willie. So I have a map set up what I want to achieve and somewhat how the game would be played. I just gotta figure out how and what each individual card would do. Well, like I said before, work backwards, because you have to have the objective you want first before you start planning on anything else. Otherwise, you're gonna be putting yourself too much to the limits and you won't know what to do. Yeah, what kind of ideas? So, okay, so with three rolls, there were with their own individual piles, I have a plan for my drawings and specific cards. Okay. Is it okay if I give an example of card pile differences? Yeah, sure, go ahead. I don't want to feel like you like can't talk about stuff. What's her name again? Leah, I think. MTF lands on a card, lands on a gainer card square. They gain an SCP containment item like 173 or 4. 131 for 173. Oh. If scientists land on a gainer card space, they gain info, which is how they win. Okay. Nice. I've already talked with you, I have no interest in you. SCP, start the game with one SCP card. Let's use 173, and these cards have to be contained by MTF. MTF items for MTF to win, and they all have their own way of moving based on the SCP. So let me just refresh chat. Don't say anything. Well, I look forward to hearing how you're gonna think about that. Interesting, I can right click on things. Yeah, I think set movement will probably work out best for you. You also got to keep in mind some of the later SCPs as well, the 2000s, 3000 series as well. Nice. Let's say 096 can move 2 rooms per turn because he is slow, but if there's going to be a straightaway, someone would give a move buff. Yeah, I think it would work. You'd have to make it to whoever plays on the SCP team pulls a random card from the SCP pile. Elohim. Just give me a second, I'm trying to get my cat to stop being. Well, I'm saying the 3000 series, not just the 3000. Just read up on them. Just go through the site. A 100 G stone clay cup. Yeah, they are, but I love them to bits. What is this noise? It's so ominous. Are you gonna try to take my advice and doing it an SCP in a different pose? You can still use the reference image to like figure like the proportions and whatnot, but try like going aside from the picture. Because drawings, no matter how skilled they are, can always be improved upon. Well, throw in a few object SCPs as well. Like the red tablet that can make you see the other side. Maybe, but I think the first post image I'm gonna do is running away D-class witch, or which will be tomorrow on or Sunday.
Yeah.
Once you try out different, once you try different things, it'll be better. Also, my stream's behind again. God damn it. Yeah. Also, the mask I drew today make me realize that there's one specific nose is hard to make. Oh, yeah. One of the things I hate drawing most is noses. Noses and feet. Zed. Well, I'm glad my cat doesn't mess with my VTuber. Any animal face that's long is hard to do. Short things like cats and birds are fine. Horses, dogs, etc. Well, why not? my drawings today weren't the best, so I'm going to try to do super good to redeem myself. I mean, there's... Everybody has their own skill and their own, like, growth to it, I guess. Just keep on practicing, no matter what. Try to stay away from JSCPs. Yeah, that's understandable. Problem with 682 is that it's also amorphous. There's no set form to it. All it is a quadrupedal lizard. That's all people know. I still got time of the day, I'll have to go scavenging. I'm proud of this game as long as I don't go to bed one night and forget out that I added all that I added the previous day. Are you talking about the game or on Stardew? down somewhere. Write down in like a book. Take it from someone who works in video game development. All the best writers have like books or notepads or something. Oh, I wonder if that woman is still here. Yeah, that makes sense. Well, even if you just keep it in your phone or something. Also, holy fuck, my phone is behind. Tiny cat sleeping on my arm. Stupid headset. Yeah. Scientists would probably be a good start. Like how the scientists are escaping them. How the scientists are going to like win and then backwards from there. By the way, I posted a picture of my cat on my Twitter. I have a Twitter, but I don't use it very often. Mainly because I don't like Twitter. Yay, sword. So based on how many SCPs can move and how work, how many info credits should they have to work? Just one each. You know, I can always get more. Okay, so for things like picking up cards, I would definitely suggest looking at the house or Betrayal on the House on the Hill. That's what it's called. Like, before you do anything, look up on that one, because then you can see how you can do like a laboratory kind of scenario. Off me so I can see. Oh boy. Now, but for now, I was thinking like 5 info cards with how common they were in my current setup, and that also gives me an idea for recipes. Okay. Recipes want another recipe, so they would have to go to other recipe sites, and that's where they can draw.
Yeah.
The thing with Betrayal, it's like you reveal a house park card, like a room or whatever, and then that thing it says like, oh, there's a a mystery thing here, and then you can go from there. So you could just have it randomly draw from there. Sorry, just tossing something for my cat. I guess he wants to play now, huh?
Give me that.
His toy's bigger than him and he wants to play! Sure he's entertained, or he's gonna be Grouch Puss. The nice thing is my cat plays fetch. Snips. Are those the best kind of traps, though? Scarecrow basic fertilizer. Might as well make a furnace. Yeah, furnace. My cat would lay on her back, meow that for attention. When you pet her, she would claw and bite us. She doesn't do it anymore, though. She has gotten lovelier. My cat used to as well, but he loves tummy rubs now. Tomorrow I'm gonna work with that D&D tiles I told you about and make an SCP board and play test it with other makers.
Yeah, sure.
Elohim. Bring your damn toy. supposed to make a D&D Pokemon on top of D&D games are so rare and D&D is being used for the SCP purpose. Yeah. My cousin responds tomorrow since we are working on map design. Also, the tile idea makes it to our SCP. Yeah. Well, I'm glad I can help out with ideas, even if it's just a little bit. What do you mean a little bit? I may have been the one brainstorming, but all my ideas either were changed or made by you. Well, maybe call it a self-confidence flaw. I may act all confident and whatnot, but I'll be straight with you. Deep down, I'm a huge ball of anxiety. That's what streams are for. Yeah. You be chillin' and enjoy yourself. That's all I ever want for people. It's just to be chill. If we were all a little bit more chill, maybe the world would be a better place. But hey, that's just me. maybe post-marriage, you know how much I dislike my Arbiter Bliss. Every artist, unfortunately, has that folly. The artist's mind is the worst thing to an artist. Straight up. But hey, you gotta get your name out there somehow. And if you don't post it, who else is gonna tell you when things suck? Like, really? No, I'll be straight with you. There'll be times where... Oh, fuck. I might have an artist, but sadly the heads for it. I'm still practice, my dude. We all didn't start off good. You have to practice for it. Trust me, when I first started off as an artist, I will be quite frank with you, I sucked. I mean, whereas I can speed draw something in my head, see every stroke with the pencil, but I can never make these. Yeah, but like I said, it's all practice. That's all I can say to you is continuously practice. Ice cream. Gotta love trash cream. I might need a drawing tablet because that's what I see my mind doing. Yeah, find something, even if you go on like Wish or something and find something for dirt cheap. Thank you. Asmodeus. Of course, he's a wizard. Not like you have a chillness as a superpower. Which is funny, because it's the entire point of my VTuber career is that it's the complete opposite. Like, I'm, like, hot fire. But like I said, I just want people to treat it like a bonfire. Come talk about what you want. Asshole cat. Getting pigs are spoiled, I give them lettuce and they don't eat it immediately because they were waiting for a carrot or a snack. Why are you such a nutter? Seriously. Oh boy. I'm definitely a crazy cat dad. There is, yes. That was my cat. I let him purr into the mic sometimes because he likes to be a social boy. I definitely think so. My roommate, his cats are a little bit more vicious, and yet my cat still tries to love and purr with everybody. Definitely think the owner has as much effect on the pet as the pet has effect on the owner. Yeah, I mean, he's always welcome to listen if he really wants to, but he has to make an account. God, I'm high! I do not remember this. Strawberry rhubarb pie is my favorite. You plan on streaming tomorrow? What's tomorrow? Possibly, I'll have to see. Most of my stream is very sporadically scheduled. Just whenever I can get in some gaming, because I have a lot of things I need to deal with. Being unemployed in this day and age doesn't really help. If I was a little bit more famous, I would have liked to make a career out of streaming, but I don't think it's going to work out very much. Come on, keyboard work. Nice. guess I should probably go get parsnips and whatnot. Alright, you know what? I think I'm gonna go probably call it there for the night. It was actually really nice to chill and stream. Yeah, so regardless, I hope everybody has a good night or whatever. It's 11 my time, so I'm just mentally fried. But hopefully everybody enjoyed themselves, and yeah, take care.